other way. Lord, I don't have this. I don't have this. But you know what? You got God. You got everything.
Exactly,
you know?
Right.
And that's the way we need to look at it. We need to look at the goodness of God every day. This morning, what I do love about, you know, the modern phones, where you can get Facebook, you can get the Bible Hub that's got all the different translations. I love that. And that's why I get up early in the morning, because I can spend time. I get up about 4:15. You can spend time with the Lord. It's quiet. And you can just celebrate and see what He's going to give you for that day. And one of the things he gave me this morning was about Isaiah 61. And you know what is so awesome? Of course, Jesus read this when He stood up to read, because we know it's about Him. But He talked to Spirit 60. This is Isaiah 61. The Spirit of the Almighty Lord is with me, because the Lord has anointed me to deliver good news. Isn't that something?
Yeah.
We all need good news,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Good news to humble people. He has sent me to heal those who are brokenhearted, to announce that captives will be set free and prisoners will be released. He has sent me to announce the year of the Lord's goodwill,
yeah,
and the day of our God's vengeance, to comfort all those. It didn't say some.
Uh-huh.
It doesn't say some. It said all those,
yeah,
hallelujah, who grieve. He has sent me to provide for all those who grieve in Zion, to give them crowns instead of ashes, the oil of joy instead of tears of grief, the clothes of praise instead of a spirit of weakness. They will be called oaks of righteousness and the plantings of the Lord, so that He might display His glory.
Yeah.
Just think about it. That's what God wants to do in your life. You know, He wants to display His glory in you.
Yeah.
People say, what is that hope? Why do you act the way you do? Because it's Jesus.
Yes.
You know, we all know, heard the story of Alexander the Great, and where one of his soldiers was deserting, sleeping on the job, and they told him about it, and he went to him. The problem was, the soldier had the same name as Alexander the Great. And you think about Alexander the Great, to have that name. I mean, he had 15 years, he won victories in a row. And Alexander the Great, and this guy says, is it true? You know, you've been sleeping on the job, you've been deserted, you're not, and he told him, he said, this is what's going to happen. You know, you either change your conduct or you change your name. You're not going to be named after me, Alexander, and act that way. Hey, let's think about Jesus. You know, we got certain ways we got to act when we call the name of Jesus Christ.
Yes.
And that way we need to act holy and act right, and it starts from the inside out. That's where the changes happen. From the inside out. When God is good to you, you have to, it bursts out of you.
It does.
It comes out of you. You can't help but pray. If somebody comes up to you and says, would you pray for me? You're not going to blow, oh, I don't know. No, I will pray for you.
Yes.
Yeah.
I will seek the Lord on your behalf. That's what it's about. That's what, you know, to be able to pray, to me, that's absolutely amazing. To be able to pray to the King of Kings, Lords of Lords, and He hears what you're saying. You know, I don't have to get a knock on the door, you know, and say, hey, God, can I come in now? Come on in. Come right on in. That temple was rent. We could walk in the holies of holies and talk to God.
Amen.
And that's what we want to do tonight, and realize what God has called us to. He wants to put that glory inside of us and shine out, just like a lighthouse, shine out. And tonight we're going to open this up. Anybody like to praise the Lord, tell us others what God has done for you? The floor is open. Yes, Berto.
I just want to thank God for all the good things that are happening in my life. I would like, you can join me in prayer and standing, that you know, God's going to reveal to me what I'm supposed to do based on some things that are happening right now in my life. They're good, don't get me wrong. But I just want to make sure that whatever steps I take are because I'm being directed by Him.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. 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 He's going to direct your steps. That's one good thing about the Lord. Always look, Jesus said, come follow me. I always look at that verse. He said, come follow me. If we're following Him, He's walking ahead of us, right?
Yeah.
And He's already been there. You know, we used to read in, you know, the Bread of Life books and different things, you know. Don't worry about tomorrow. God's already there. And that's what we have to remember. You know, He's already walked that step. He understands what we're going through.
Yes.
The God that knew you before you was in your mom's belly, I think He can take care of you.
Yeah.
You know, and we get so lost in that. I don't know if God's going to come through. I'd listen to some of the saints, and they would say, well, he's never failed me yet. You know, they'd always say that. He never failed me. I said, why do you even say yet?
Exactly.
You ought to leave that yet off. I'm not believing God will ever fail me.
Exactly.
He's going to do the things the way he wants to do, his good pleasure. Sometimes it may not fit the way we want, but God's working out everything. Everything. One time I had a person come to me, and they was worried about later in their life, you know, having kids. Oh, I've done this wrong. I've done this wrong. I've done this wrong. And, you know, God gives you illustrations and stuff. And I said, you know, it's the way we used to bake a cake the old way. Now you got it all mixed. But, you know, before you used to put the eggs and salt and sugar and flour. And I used to hate that the way it looked in the bowl. I just thought that was so gross. I wasn't one that licked the bowl because I just thought it was so gross. So you stir it all up. And you put it in the oven, then you start smelling it, seeing it rise. And then we got a cake that you can enjoy. That's what God does with our life. The good and the bad, he stirs it all up. And he brings something good out of it. That's what he does. You know, I know I say this before, but, you know, people ask me, Tim, does God give up on you? Does God give you a second chance? I said, no way. No, he never gives you second chances. It's like third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh. He goes on out. If he gave up on us a second chance, we all be goners,
yeah.
Right?
Right.
You don't do that with your kids. If they screw up the second time, you're out of here. You don't do that. You bear with them. You pray for them. Hey, let's set out and figure this out. We're going to lift you up to the Lord every single day. You know what? Because God, you didn't come on this earth for no reason. You have a purpose for your life. And God wants to give you that purpose and drive. There's a reason for you're here. Okay, so that we're going to bear with you. We're going to always stay with you. Someone else.
Come on.
Yes.
My life's been one lesson after another.
Amen.
I started up the street at the treatment center. And after 4 months, I had to leave there. The time's up. And I went to a place where I'm staying now, and it's time to move on. And I was going to move Monday to the house, Freedom House. It's a spiritual house, by grace. And the lady called me on Sunday and said, we changed our mind. We want you, it's a better house, and it's organized.
Amen.
Well, on the east, you know, I was kind of, you know what? But I hung up. As soon as I hung up, I thought, you know, this is where God wants me.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't, he didn't want me over by the Drake area, he wanted me here.
Amen.
Woo! It's a new beginning.
That's right.
A new door open.
Yeah.
There's a purpose for it.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Glory.
God's good. God's good. He always knows what's best. That's why the Bible starts the way it does. It starts in the beginning God, doesn't it? It doesn't start once upon a time because it's not a fairy tale. You ever notice that fairy tales start like that? No, this ain't a fairy tale. This is real. In the beginning God. Somebody asked me, when did God start? I don't know, but he started way back in the beginning. God always was. You know, he always will be. He's a present God in a time of help. He's right here with us tonight. Okay, someone else. Someone else. When he said, not my will. Because he said first, if this cup passed by me, then he said, not my will. And that's what we got to come to. Not my will, but whatever you want. Father, whatever you want, I'll do it.
Yeah.
And the victory is won. He went to the cross. And then even on the cross, you know, some was going after him. Yeah, if you're the Son of God, we'll believe you now. If you come down the cross and all this. You know, and Jesus still wasn't thinking about himself. You ever see that? You know, he said, Father, forgive them. They know not what they do. Then the thief on the cross. You know, I love the thief that repented. You know what he said? Remember me. He didn't say he didn't have a lot of time left, you know. And he didn't say, he said, remember me. And Jesus could have said, you know what? I got a lot going on right now. I'll consider your case a little later. Did he say that?
No.
He said, this day. Exactly. This day you're going to be in prayer. This day. He thought about others. And he died like this.
Yeah.
You know, one person said he died like this with his arms wide open.
Right.
So welcome you. One time I was in, my daughter used to live in Philadelphia. And I just loved the way they had this cross set up. It's a little different. I stopped on the corner. I was walking, go across traffic. And I thought, this is actually, it's a really good picture. One way to look at the Bible is a really good picture. And what it was Jesus on the cross. And he had one hand up here. And the other was down here, reaching out. And I just thought, what a picture. What I stuck it on top of the church, and I thought, what a picture. Here's the cross, and he's out here reaching out. Are you going to take what he's done for you? I thought that was so powerful. I never forgot that image. I thought, that's it. That's it. He was willing. Then he asked you the same question. Are you willing? Are you willing to go all the way with him? For somebody that's done so much. He died for us, surely we got to live for him. Surely, every day of our life should be in gratitude for what God has done. Every single day.
Amen.
Someone else. Yes.
Just for grateful for a week off of vacation and just kicking back and enjoying time with family and with the Lord and getting caught up on a few things. Just stress-free for the most part.
Amen. That's good. Enjoy that time with family because that's what it's all about. That's what it's all about, family. That's what we think about most. Not about money. A lot of people have money and don't have family. Some people don't have any money, but they got family. And what do you want most? It's family. At the end of your life, I've never seen it. I know you heard it before. I've never seen anybody.
Yeah.
You don't talk, well, I wonder, man, I'm getting close to, it's about wrapping my life up. I wonder how my 401k is doing. You know? I wonder, man, I should have bought more stock at BP. Oh, this is going to be bad. No, he said, bring my kids. I want to see them. I want to see my grandkids. When my mom was close to death, you know what she wanted to see? All of her kids. That's what she wanted to see. She wanted to tell them, I love them. I love them. I love them. And one day I'll see you on the other side.
Yes.
That's what she wanted to tell them that. She wasn't worried about the money and stuff. Can't take it with you anyway. Okay, someone else. Someone else. Yes, sir. Someone else. Yes.
Yeah, like you were saying, God never gives up on us. He's always trying to draw us closer. If we want to come, you know, he draws. And that's what makes it good. And God is always wanting to use us more. And, you know, when people talk about the day that they got saved, well, that was just beginning, you know,
that's right.
The starting point. And salvation is a ourselves up, but it's something where God is showing how the unity is such a good and conducive atmosphere,
yes.
You know, to grow in love, because that's what God is, you know. We can all be what He wants us to be. Of course, we don't even know what that is. We're
sure.
Just trying to
yeah.
find our way along, but with God's help and lifting up our leadership and everybody that's participating, brothers and sisters, everybody. It's just great to see as you go out and about and you meet all kinds of people. It's great to see what God's doing and others too. And Roberto's mom and sister, they're all over the place.
Yeah.
And you just can't outdo God. You can't outpace Him. You can't forget about Him. He's always reaching out and building us up where we should be, and that's no part on ourselves to glory in, but just more of Him. It's
yes.
great. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Yes.
So awesome. 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 Okay. Anyone else like to share what God has done? Okay. Can we stand and for prayer, please?
Hallelujah.
Father God,
yes, Lord.
You are good. Hallelujah. We want more of you. More of you. More of you, Lord. Tonight we come to lift you up. It's all about you, Lord. It's all about having your heart. As they said, David was a man after God's own heart. Hallelujah. Let us have your heart in us. As it said in the verse, create a clean heart in me. Hallelujah. A new heart. A heart that can feel the beating. Hallelujah. There's so many people out there that don't know you, Lord. Let this be the time that we can be the lights that shine. Hallelujah. That we know the reason that the hope that's in us. That Jesus Christ has made the difference in us. Hallelujah. That we can pray to you. And Father God, that our prayers go above the ceiling. They go all the way to the throne. And it's all about you, Lord. Father God, teach us to grow in you, Lord. Teach us to spend more time in your word and realize that you gave us beauty, beauty for ashes. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus, that you have done so much for our lives. Surely, Lord, surely we're going to praise you. Surely we're going to thank you all of our days, Lord, all of our days, because you are so wonderful, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. We lift you up, Lord. Hallelujah. And we're going to praise you tonight for being here, because that's why we came tonight, to worship you, the only true and wise God, our Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. And we want to thank you and praise you tonight in your wonderful, and I say that a lot, our wonderful,
yes.
wonderful, wonderful holy name,
yes.
we pray. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. All right. This Friday, June 12th at 7 p.m., Easton Gate House of Prayer. If all you come out and join us,
amen.
It's always a good time. You know why? Because Jesus is here.
Yes. Yes.
That's what makes it a good time.
Yes.
You know, because He's here and He wants to spend time with us too.
Yes.
And we want to spend time with Him and lift Him up.
Hallelujah.
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 Okay. All right. Now we're going to declare the word.
Yes, Lord.
Will you not revive us again, that your people may rejoice in you? Hallelujah. Okay. I am a believer, and these signs do follow me. In the name of Jesus, I cast out demons. I speak in new tongues. I lay hands on the sick, and they do recover. Hallelujah. Christ has redeemed me from the curse of the law. Therefore, I forbid any sickness or disease to come upon this body. Every disease, germ, and every virus that touches this body dies instantly in the name of Jesus. Every organ and every tissue of this body functions to the perfection to which God created it to function. And I forbid any malfunction in this body in the name of Jesus. I received the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him, the eyes of my understanding being enlightened, and I am not conformed to this world, but am transformed by the renewing of my mind. My mind is renewed by the word of God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. The Lord rebukes the devourer for my sake, and no weapon that is formed against my finances will prosper. All obstacles and hindrances to my financial prosperity are now dissolved. The Lord has pleasure in the prosperity of his servant, and Abraham's blessings are mine. Hallelujah. 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 Brother Juan, you come on. Call Brother Juan. If y'all want to be seated.
Catching on.
All right. Would you pray for the offering, please? Amen. Thank you. All right. Praise God. Thank you.
Hallelujah.
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 Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Brother Tim, for stepping up to the plate at the last second. Really appreciate it.
Hallelujah. What a gift.
What a gift. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. You brought Tim and Lee have come into our midst as the Holy Spirit had guided and directed. And in August, Viviana will be with us too. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. You are worthy. You are worthy, Lord.
I'm gonna join with heaven and earth to sing together praise to the King.
All of creation.
All creation is waiting for you. You love everything that you made.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. You are worthy, 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 Lord. Sacrifice, God's perfect Son gave up His life to ransom back the lost and damned. Christ stood in Christ, justice demands. As He was broken, heaven was open. Our good confessed, our sins acquitted. His loving kindness free invites us into the realm of grace. Sing a new song, sing of His goodness, sing of His goodness, sing of His wonderful love. True love was shown, true love defined. As He was scorned and crucified, He tore the veil, bridged the divide, taking us from darkness to light. As He was broken, heaven was open, our judgment lifted, our sins acquitted. His loving kindness freely invites us into the realm of grace. Sing a new song, sing of His goodness, sing of His goodness, sing of His wonderful love. Sing a new song, sing of His goodness, sing of His faithfulness.
Faithfulness, sing a new song to
all about you, Lord. It's all about you, Lord. It's all about you, Lord.
Yo no quiero ser igual.
new creatures, Lord. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Mike, Tammy, and James. Praise God. It's a beautiful day today. I will try to be brief. This is my first time doing this. But I'm really excited. You know, when Pastor asked me if I wanted to do this, I don't know, I felt like it was confirmation of the Holy Spirit that this is something that he wants me to do. And I felt very honored that, you know, God spoke to him to ask me to do this. So I want to share some things with you. What I want to talk to you today, I want to talk to you about freedom. This is something that has been in my heart. And I feel some of the things that I'm going to share with you today, the Holy Spirit put in my heart, and this is some things that have been revealed to me during this past 2 years in the beginning of my journey as a Christian, as a follower of Jesus Christ. And these things, you know, have allowed me to see and experience God in a different way, a way that I have never experienced him before. Because I did know about God, but I did not know God.
Right.
So I want to start by reading from the book of John, chapter 8, verse 36. Mike, if you please. Okay. So it says, if the Son therefore shall make you free, you shall be free indeed. Amen. I've read this verse many times. In my opinion, I feel that this is one of the verses that is most misused, you know, of all the verses in the Bible. And it's mostly misused by our legal system, which is, it's a little sad, because if you go to a courtroom, I've never been to one, but I believe they have in the back wall the phrase, in God we trust,
right.
You know. But if you truly trusted God, you wouldn't be using this verse the way they do. You know, I've seen this verse used many times to trick people or sometimes coerce them into admitting things, some sort of wrongdoing that they've been accused of. And in doing so, they're giving that person the false hope that by admitting to such wrongdoing, they're going to walk away free. And that's not the reality. You know, our society has certain rules that we have to follow,
right.
Although there's a higher authority that we have to follow. But since we are in this world, we have to follow those rules, and telling a person, you know, if you say the truth, you're gonna be free. Well, yeah, spiritually, but you're gonna go to jail, you know, if you're guilty. So I don't believe that truth that it's trying to be misused by the people that misuse this verse is not the truth that Jesus is talking about, you know, in this verse. We as humans, as I mentioned, we are subjected to the laws of this world. And because of that, we have to deal with everything that came as a result of the fall. You know, we have to deal with sickness, we have to deal with diseases, we have to deal with feelings and everything that we have to experience as a human. It's because of those things that we sometimes can become bonded. And there's things around us that we put emphasis on that
are tying us to this world and preventing us from moving in a spiritual way to where we're supposed to be. So, you know, you can ask yourself, well, how do I become free? If you could go over to Matthew chapter 5, verse 17, please. It says, think not that I am come to destroy the law or the prophets. I am not come to destroy, but to fulfill. So Jesus came to this earth to fulfill everything that the prophets had spoken.
Right.
He came to make sure that whatever was spoken by the prophets would come to pass according to the will of God.
Yes.
So when Tim was standing here earlier and he was talking, I was sitting there and I was smiling because God has a way of tying everything together.
Yes.
One of the things that was spoken by the prophets was that he came to set us free. So if you can go to Isaiah chapter 61, verse 1. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me, because the Lord hath anointed me to preach good tidings unto the meek. He hath sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and the opening of the prison to them that are bound. Anyone say praise the Lord?
Praise the Lord.
Now that's good news right there.
Yes.
If Jesus came to fulfill the prophets, it says there in Isaiah that he came to give us good news, to mend our broken hearts, to give us liberty, and to remove the binds.
Yes.
Yep.
So that's it. Jesus was crucified and he died, and all of this was fulfilled.
Yes.
So us as believers are free, and we have nothing to worry about. Am I right?
Right.
So if that's so, why don't we see that more amongst believers? It's because we put our focus in the wrong place.
Yes.
Right.
Amen.
So I'm going to tell you a story. This is a story of Jack and Bill. I came up with the names, but this is a true story. Jack and Bill work together. They also go to the same church. Jack was saved a few years before and started going to the church that Bill attends. But there's one particular thing about Bill. Bill happens to be the pastor of the church. Bill likes to use his position as the pastor of the church to ask certain things of Jack. Jack believes that there is an order that needs to be followed, and because of this, he complies with those things that Bill asks of him. But Jack isn't happy. He does not feel that he is receiving word from the sermons that are being preached by Bill, but rather condemnation. Jack is not allowed to accept invitations from other believers to come visit their church without first asking permission from Bill. Jack wants to leave Bill's church, but he's afraid to do so because he still needs to see Bill on a daily basis at work. And he feels that there's going to be some animosity between them. So now I ask you this, could you be happy in a situation like this? I know I couldn't. That's the reason why I left the church in the first place. Mm-hmm. A few years ago, I started going to a church with a cousin of mine, and one of the first things that I was told when I walked through the doors, at the time, I used to have earrings. I had earrings for about 12 years. And they were like, oh, we're so happy that you're here, but you know, with those earrings, you're not going to go to heaven. What kind of a welcome is that, you know? So that's why I left. That's when Arianna told me, before we got married, she said, when we go to Iowa, I want us to start going to a church. I told her, God don't, and I don't see eye to eye, so you can go by yourself. So what do we need to do? Well, we need to change our focus. We need to look at the things that are revealed to us through the Word of God so that we can understand what Jesus came to do for us. So, Mike, if you could go over to 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 18. While we look not at the things which are seen, but at the things which are not seen, for the things which are seen are temporal, but the things which are not seen are eternal. We as believers cannot allow ourselves to be subdued to a person or a situation that is preventing us to enjoy what the Lord has promised us. In doing so, if we allow ourselves to be subdued to this either this person or situation, we are allowing them to put us in a position of bondage that does not allow us to have the relationship with God that He wants us to have. Amen. So here's another example. I was under bondage for many years because when I was an adolescent, I tried to open a Bible that my grandmother had on top of her dresser. And when she saw me doing so, she yelled at me, put that down. And I got scared. I'm like, okay, why? She said, well, because if you're going to read the Bible, you have to be taught. Otherwise, you're going to go crazy like your cousin. And, you know, I believed that for a long time. And I didn't open a Bible until 2 years ago, because I was afraid that I was going to go crazy. But I'm glad I did.
Yes. Hallelujah. Amen.
So, we need to make sure that we put our focus in the things that are eternal.
Yes.
We as believers, we receive many gifts from God. And one of those is His Holy Spirit. The Bible says that our body is a temple of the Holy Spirit. So that means that the Holy Spirit dwells inside of us. Mm-hmm. So if you could go over, Mike, to 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 17. And it is because we have the Holy Spirit inside of us that this verse is confirmed. Now the Lord is that Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty.
Amen.
The English Standard Version of the Bible translates this verse as, where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom.
Amen. Amen.
Can you say it with me? Freedom.
Freedom.
With freedom, there is no fear. With freedom, there is no condemnation.
That's right.
With freedom, there is no guilt.
That's right.
No anxiety. Or whatever else this world or the devil can try to do to us to subject us to what can hold us down.
Yes.
If you can go back, Mike, to John chapter 8, but this time, I need verses 31 through 36, please. Then said Jesus to those Jews which believed on him, "If you continue in my word, then are ye my disciples indeed. And ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free." They answered him, "We be Abraham's seed, and were never in bondage to any man. How sayest thou, ye shall be made free?" Jesus answered them, "Verily, verily, I say unto you, whosoever committeth sin is the servant of sin. And the servant abideth not in the house forever, but the Son abideth ever. If the Son therefore shall make you free, you shall be free indeed."
Amen.
There's one word in particular that caught my attention in those verses, and it's the word abide.
Yeah.
I looked up the definition of the word abide, and this is what I found. Abide is to accept or act in accordance with. We need to abide in the Word of God.
Yes.
So if we're going to apply that definition, we need to accept the Word of God. We need to act in accordance to the Word of God.
Exactly.
We need to believe what God is telling us. Mm-hmm. And when we do this, we will understand that whom the Son sets free is free indeed.
Yes.
Yes.
So that is my message for you today. I told you it was short, but just remember, we are free from everything that can tie us down in this world.
Hallelujah.
So let's give him a hand clap. All right. Well, that's all I have. So, you're dismissed.